Approach, mortal. Mortal, you stand above the sealed ruins of Leloria. Within is a gateway to Cold Harbor, where my priestess, Kulanwe, suffers at the hands of Molag Bal. Her pain is so great, it has torn a hole between worlds. This injustice must end. I am the Daedric, Prince of Dawn and Dusk, who weeps for Kulanwe's suffering. I am the Mother of the Rose, who sealed Leloria away from your world. I am Azura, mortal, and I would have you end Kulanwe's endless torment. Long ago, the wizard Vestari came to Leloria. She sought to end Kulanwe's suffering, but Vestari failed and was lost. Go to Vestari's tower, retrace her path into Leloria, and mortal, set Kulanwe's bones to rest. Vestari kept careful records of her struggle to pierce Leloria's seal. They remain scattered in her tower. Find them. Use them to breach the seal and recover Kulanwe. A powerful wizard who built the tower behind you. She studied Leloria for years, always patient, until finally she found a way through. But despite her preparations, Molag Bal's servants overwhelmed her companions. She was forever lost. Leloria is the mouth of a bottle that floats through Cold Harbor. My seal is the cork. Should I release the seal, Molag Bal's servants will pour into Leloria until they have nowhere else to go but here. Vestari found a way to slip past the seal, as must you. Kulanwe was the most beloved of my servants. Her voice bent the world to her will, yet she used her power for selfless works until she was taken to Cold Harbor. Molag Bal made her song of pain last millennia. But in his distraction, you will recover her.
Thank you. again? I mean, yes, mortal? Greetings, outsider. As the will of my prince is eternal, I heed your call. Azura. You know of Azura, don't you? Irai, the fleet, she named me. But that was long ago. This shriveled vessel is but a shadow of my former glory. My wings ache to soar the skies of oblivion once more. The Starry pierced the seal with a relic known as the Twilight Heart. It still stands before the gates of Leloria, bereft of magical energies. You'll need to feed it souls, and with all these Daedra about, you'll have your pick. The wizard Vastari kept quite the stock of sigil geodes, which I suppose should do. There are still some around. I can smell them from here. Of course, she was the last to summon me. Together we opened the ruins of Leloria. She ventured in with her noble companions. I watched them die in a flood of Daedra. It was all I could do to escape and seal the ruin. Vastari's final command. Ignoring the fact that my prince's unbreakable will compels me to open the way to Leloria, despite the unspeakably bloody terror to greet you on the other side. You could be Molag Bal himself for all I know. I'd still help you open the door, Lord of Brutality or not. You aren't him, are you? Good, good. I'd expect the Harvester of Souls to be taller. Try waiting in a rock until someone calls your name! Then watch them reduce to a smear of viscera the moment you do what they've asked you to do. You try to find joy where you can. The joy of aiding another, of course. Of course, she was the last to... Simple to use. Point it at the Daedra you want to absorb, and the sigil geo does the rest. A pretty stone, yes? But it will remain dull as an old torture puppet until you filled it with Daedric souls. Point it at any Daedra and concentrate. Your target will be mesmerized by its faceted glow until the hapless fool is drawn into the stone. And take care with your aim. Yes, but only the least of them. It won't work on a Daedric prince if that's what you're thinking. It might work, but if you tried, who would help you open Leloria? The impertinence. Yes, but a pretty stone, yes. Yeah. just so. The power! I'd forgotten how it feels! Follow, outsider! Come see my prince's glorious domain!
Yes, here I am, despite your efforts.
My prince's children were legion. They should have overwhelmed you.
Molag Bal's chattel are nothing to me.
Blasphemy!
Stranger, if you're a foe to Molag Bal, stand with me.
Fools! I'll feast upon your eyes!
Nowhere to fly, fiend.
You won't escape. You'll die in here like the others. You won't escape.
The sigil geode? Do you still have it? Touching the sigil geode to Arai's forehead will absorb her soul. It's the only way we'll ever leave this place. If she dies outside of that stone, we'll spend the next century counting the tiles in this place. I noted 32,708, but you're welcome to check my figures. In the depths of this ruin is a portal leading straight to Cold Harbor. We can only close it from the other side. Once in Cold Harbor, we'll have no hope of escape unless Irai is inside that stone. Quickly! I can't keep this up for long.
It doesn't matter what you do to me. You'll be dead or trapped for 1,000 years. Molag Bal is my prince, you fool! I let Vistari believe I was Azura's servant, just as I let you believe. I led you into Cold Harbor's grasp, morsels for the god of schemes to pick from between his teeth. You can never truly escape Cold Harbor, soul shriven. My prince always gets what he wants. If you escaped, it's because he allowed it. Do it! I've spent countless centuries imprisoned in a tablet. That stone would be a delightful change of scenery. Perhaps the Banekin will pick it from your corpse and bring me to my prince. Wouldn't that be wonderful?
At last, after all these years. I'm not one to hope any creature suffers, but with Irai, I'll make an exception. She can spend eternity in the sigil geode for all I care. Irai is bound to her tablet. While she's within the sigil geode, we can use her as a tether to escape from Cold Harbor. If I hadn't been so quick to destroy her those years ago, my companions would still be alive. Come. We should retrieve Kulanwe. At the base of these ruins is the hole her torment tears between worlds. But the moment we enter, Molag Bal's servants are likely to sense our presence. I'd have long ago made the attempt myself, if I had anywhere to flee. We must find Kulan Wei and free her from whatever cruel device causes her so much pain. Doing so should end her torment. When she no longer cries out, the rift between Cold Harbor and Leiloria should close, I hope. I kept this library clear of Daedra, but the chambers beyond are home to a variety of the creatures. It may be best to avoid them. always reaching for her last memories of a life free of suffering. No more! Come, we... freed Kulanwe from her torment. Oh, it was worth the wait. Irai brought us both through the seal. It's only fitting she bring us back. I can use the sigil Geo to trace her soul back, and then it's a simple matter to open a portal. Are you ready? Then prepare yourself. Departing Cold Harbor is never easy. It is good to stand beneath the sky once more, to feel the breeze upon my skin. And I wouldn't have made it here without you. My home is always open to you, should you care to visit.
88 years, 3 months, 11 days, 13 hours, 7 minutes. All right, I'm showing off. I used a simple spell to mark the time. It was the first thing I did when I realized I was trapped. It's not entirely precise, so I had to guess the minutes. Clear my Tower of Daedra, for one. Memorialize my companions who did not return. Organize my effects. Then I'll find out what has transpired in this world since I left. I have some catching up to do. I opened my home to many I met in my travels. A young Redguard swordsman, a scarred wood elf hunter, a Psijic outcast. I can still hear their voices. But that was 90 years ago. Those not killed by the Daedra must have fled. For a time, though I expect my attention shall be drawn elsewhere soon enough, there was something different in Cold Harbor. The air was a little too full, the fires too bright. Molag Baal's Corner of Oblivion holds many secrets. I plundered several from his halls a lifetime ago. Did you know? I did it to impress a boy. What a fool I was. Telekar, a powerful mage, brilliant, always focused upon his work, hardly striking, though such things never matter to me. It took my escapade in Cold Harbor to convince him there were adventurous women outside of his books, but that was long ago.
Kulanwe, beloved of the Wild Ones, my priestess returns from the clutches of Cold Harbor at last. So I have seen. A mortal has managed what the eternal dead could not. Much when it is time. You have taught humility to a Daedric prince, mortal. Tread carefully. For he will attempt to exact his revenge. Now go with my blessing. When I have need of you, you will know. Much.